Okay, welcome to this edition of Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries. I'm your host, John Krupa. Today's case is a final appeals case. And this is a very important final appeals case because this case just keeps flip-flopping back and forth. Since 1997, we have been confused on whether this man is innocent or guilty. Richard Glossip is our focus today, guys. And if you have any information on this case, read these places and contact them. Don't contact me. I'm just an artist. Can't do anything with the info. This took place in Oklahoma. And Timothy McVeigh was definitely guilty of killing people, but we don't know. The mystery here is, this man guilty of doing this crime? We're going to tell you about his crime and a little bit about his case today on the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries, guys. And this, we're going to get right into it. We're going to tell you about his case and draw him at the same time. This report was from the New York Times, and it's from a unbiased reporter, so they say. What to know about the case of Richard Glossop, death row prisoner? The U.S. Supreme Court has granted a stay of execution after Oklahoma's Attorney General urged that Mr. Glossop not be put to death, citing problems in his murder trial. And here's what he really looks like in full color. And we're drawing a similar picture. The U.S. Supreme Court granted a stay of execution to Richard Glossop, who was convicted in the 1997 killing of an Oklahoma City motel owner, and will review his case further. The Supreme Court on Friday granted a stay of execution for the death row inmate Richard Glossop after Oklahoma's Attorney General made an extraordinary plea to stop what he says would have been an unthinkable error. The court put the execution on hold while it considers whether to formally review the case. He has been minutes away from getting executed three separate occasions. So even if he is guilty, you gotta admire this guy's intestinal fortitude. Imagine them going through the whole process of you getting put to death on three different occasions. It's impressive on the intestinal fortitude, but is this man guilty? We're gonna look into it, guys. Now, that request from the state attorney general, Gentner Drummond, a pro-death penalty Republican, was the latest effort to stop the scheduled May 18th execution of Mr. Glossop, who was convicted of arranging the 1997 murder of a motel owner in Oklahoma City and has been in prison for almost 25 years. Mr. Drummond argued that Mr. Glossop's conviction was sustainable and a new trial is imperative. Now, the people that's pro Richard Glossop will say that there's no evidence physical at the crime scene of him ever committing the murder. Well, they're right. He was said to have plotted a mastermind murder for hire scheme using a guy named Sneed. His last name is Sneed. I think it's Keith. But he's said to coerced this Sneed into doing Glossop's dirty work. That means the actual murder. And I watched the documentary Killing Richard Glossop on the Investigation Discovery Channel. It was good, but it was very one-sided on the pro-Richard Glossop tip. Very one-sided. And I don't think the whole story is being told, so that's why I felt compelled to do this show on him. I really don't think. I think the pro Richard Glossop story is being told, no problem. But the anti Richard Glossop story is not being told. Advocates for Mr. Glossop have argued that new evidence discovered in the independent investigations, combined with problems with the state's prosecution and the destruction of evidence, strongly suggest that there was not enough evidence to warrant a conviction, let alone a death sentence. Mr. Glossop's case has been taken on various supporters, including state lawmakers from both parties, Kim Kardashian and Mr. Drummond, who has said that carrying out a death sentence would be grave injustice. Now, I agree, the death penalty is a bit much. But I definitely think he deserves life without parole. A lot of the evidence points to him being the mastermind of this murder for hire scheme. And it is national Let It Eat Bean. Let Eat Your Beans Day. Eat it. Eat Your Beans Day. So we had to play Eat It, of course. Would you expect any less? So there is a lot of witnesses and jurors that think this man is guilty of hiring the other man to kill their boss. And the motive was pretty clear. He was friendly with the owner's wife, and he wanted the owner out of the way, so I think the owner's name was Barry. He wanted the owner out of the way so he could start running the chain of hotels that this man Barry owned. And he thought getting Barry out of the way and not doing the murder himself, hiring this kid that he hired a year prior, would be the perfect way to do it. This Keith Sneed. And that was his motive. to rob the guy. It's never been anything more, it's never been anything less. This guy is definitely a crook and a thief. And I don't care, Susan Sarandon, Kim Kardashian, they can all say whatever they want. The evidence and the witnesses and the 12 jurors, since he got tried twice. But the 24, I should say, the 24 jurors have all said he was guilty and have caught him in his lies. His stories don't match. And Keith Sneed's story was first not the truth, but then after he took the plea bargain to get him life, no matter what he says now, he's still going to get life. So he could say Richard Glossop is innocent and he would still get life. And he could say Richard Glossop is guilty and he'd still get life. So he has nothing to gain, but he's somehow, Keith Sneed is not saying this. He's saying Richard Glossop basically told him, if you don't murder Barry, you're out on your ass. Because he was living at the hotel for free, working it off with odd jobs instead of payment. And so was Mr. Glossop. He was living with his girlfriend free, being the manager of that hotel. So now back to this article from the New York Post. Governor Kevin Stitt, also a pro-death penalty Republican, has twice delayed Mr. Glossop's execution while a court evaluated his appeal. But after a parole board was split on whether to recommend clemency last month, Mr. Stitt signaled that he would not issue another stay. Now, Mr. Drummond, who does not believe Mr. Glossop was given a fair trial because of multiple errors involving both testimony and evidence, is asking the Supreme Court to intervene. If the court takes up the issue, it will do so under rare circumstances. Both the state and the defense are asking for the same thing. And Richard Glossop has lawyers that are taking his case on pro bono. But now keep in mind that these lawyers are from a big law firm that represent areas outside the country and are national. And they know that these wrongful convictions and wrongful death, they're cash cow. And of course, they're going to do it pro bono. And then when he's out, they're going to go on the wrongful incarceration. They're going to play that card. And they're going to ride Mr. Glossop as a cash cow. I just want you to ask yourself, is that a possibility? Yes, definitely. So before you get on the bandwagon with Susan Sarandon and Kim Kardashian and all these people, they don't even know the facts of the case, really. I mean, his initial things that he said while he was being investigated do not match the other things that he said. Sneed's didn't either, but then on later interrogations, they did. And it hasn't changed. In over 20 years, Sneed's statements on this case have not changed. He always said that Glossop said, you either do it or you're out on your ass. No more free places to stay. I'm the manager, so I can make it happen. And that's what I believe happened here. What is Richard Glossop accused of? Mr. Glossop, 60 years old, was convicted of arranging the 97 murder of Barry Van Treese, who owned a motel in Oklahoma City where Mr. Glossop was working as a manager. Prosecutors argued that Mr. Glossop promised the motel handyman Justin Sneed, $10,000 to kill him. Mr. Sneed ultimately pleaded guilty to first-degree murder under a deal in which he testified against Mr. Glossop and was sentenced to life in prison without parole for beating Mr. Van Treese to death. But a pair of recent investigations cast doubt on Mr. Glossop's involvement, and his lawyers and supporters argue that Mr. Sneed carried out the killing on his own. According to interviews from inmates incarcerated with Mr. Sneed on unrelated charges, Mr. Sneed said he had acted alone to rob Mr. Van Treese of the money that Mr. Sneed and his girlfriend planned to use to buy drugs. Mr. Sneed also had a history of mental illness, which was not disclosed at the time. None of the inmates' accounts were heard by the jurors who convicted Mr. Glossop and sentenced him to death. A memo recently found in the district attorney's office also detailed how the trial prosecutor worked behind the scenes with Mr. Sneed's lawyer to feed Mr. Sneed information before he testified. But they also neglect the fact that to say that jailhouse snitches are almost notoriously never reliable. There is jailhouse snitches that say Mr. Sneed acted alone. But also, Richard Glossop was found with an unusual amount of money on his person. So was Mr. Sneed. The money Mr. Sneed had blood on it. The ones that Richard Glossop had didn't. And Barry, the old hotel manager, was storing money in his trunk. It was found in his car later in the investigation. Only Glossop and Sneed knew about this. And I think their plan was maybe not to murder him, but to rob him and rough him up, get the keys to the car, take the keys, and get the money, and then bring the car back. And, you know, I think the murder, they wanted drugs. So I think the murder just happened. Mr. Glossop's execution has been rescheduled 8 times since 2015. Mr. Glossop was first convicted of capital murder in 98, but that decision was overturned in 2001 because of ineffective defense counsel. He was reconvicted in 2004 and again sentenced to death. In 2015, Mr. Glossop was granted a stay of execution shortly before he was scheduled to be put to death after he had 2 other inmates argued that Oklahoma's lethal interjection protocol was unconstitutional. The U.S. Supreme Court later upheld the state's drug protocol, and Mary Fallon, the governor at the time, issued a temporary stay for Mr. Glossop to determine whether one of the drugs used in the lethal cocktail complied with the state's regimen. Mr. Stitt has twice delayed Mr. Glossop's execution. while a court evaluated his appeals. In April, the Oklahoma Court of Criminal Appeals upheld his conviction despite the state's confession of an error. A few weeks later, the Oklahoma Pardon and Parole Board declined to recommend clemency for Mr. Glossop. The vote was 2-2, with a fifth member recusing himself. State Representative Kevin McDougall, a Republican lawmaker who supports death penalty, has said he will vote to outlaw executions in the state if Mr. Glossop is put to death. Family members of Mr. Van Treese, the victim, described Mr. Glossop during the hearing as a habitual liar. They said they did not want an innocent man to be executed, but felt Mr. Glossop was responsible for the killing. And that's what I think happened, guys. This guy tried to do something real slick and wound up murdering someone and being in direct responsibility for it. And now he's trying to talk himself out of it by lying. I don't think he should get the death penalty. And I don't think Mr. Sneed didn't get the death penalty. I don't think he should get it either. But he needs to be put away, because people like this guy shouldn't be out roaming free in the public. Okay, guys, that does it for this episode. It is Eat Your Beans Day, so we got Eat It going on in the background. Guys, I will check you out on the next episode. Peace out, true believers.